And Matt Baker will be reporting to us on what's going on with the Rickshaw Challenge, which he started on Friday and will finish next Friday, of course, on the big night. He'll be coming into Elstree, straight into the Queen Vic with the Rickshaw Challenge. They always raise an absolute ton of money for children in need. And I'll be looking forward to talking to him. He's probably wringing wet, even as we speak, but he's a great man. Now, I've got a great treat after our next piece of music, because the one show, Rickshaw Challenge for Children in Need, got off to a rocketing start on Friday, and it finishes next Friday, of course, at BBC's set of EastEnders in Elstree, where, in fact, we're doing the Children in Need telethon. And the Rickshaw Challenge is in its fourth year. It's raised over $5 million for Children in Need. And I hope to be talking to Matt Baker, if he's in sufficient physical condition to actually speak. But it does take a great deal out of him. He's a great fella. Bicycle. And we thought this would be suitable. I want to ride my We couldn't find a song that sang bicycle, Rickshaw in the title. I want to ride my bicycle is as close as we could get to it. I want to ride my bicycle. I want to ride it where I like. You say black, I say white. You say bar, I say bite. You say shark, I say him. And yours was never my scene, and I don't like Star Wars. You say Rose, I say Roy. You say God, give me a choice. Say Lord, I say Christ. I don't believe in Peter Pan, Frankenstein, or Superman. All I wanna do is great record. That's Queen, Bicycle Race. And we thought it's as close as we can get as a tribute to the Rickshaw Challenge, which has raised so much money for children in need. Five youngsters helped by children in need this year, taking part in the One Show's Rickshaw Challenge. And with them is Matt Baker. And somewhere in Britain is Matt. And he's probably exhausted, because it usually takes a great deal out of him. Good morning, Matt.
Very good morning, Terry. Is everything all right where you are?
Yes. Yeah, you sound a bit chesty, if you don't mind me saying so.
Do you know, I am, to be fair. We've had some very, very early mornings, and we've been up some extraordinary hills this morning. But we've done 27 miles already this morning, with 37 still to go to Buxton, our destination tonight.
And are you doing all the cycling?
I am. Yes, I am. I'm kind of Mr. Motivator on this one, so I'm cycling alongside and just really helping everybody along as best I can, plying them with lots of water and energy bars and general chit chat, just to try and while away the hours and the miles as they tick by.
Well, you're always a wonderful contributor, and you do brilliantly for us. But I noticed maybe last year, the year before, it also takes its toll of you emotionally, doesn't it?
It does. Well, this is the thing. I mean, it all starts out, and obviously there's reasons for the beneficiaries to be doing it and how they've helped, how they've been helped with children in need through the time. But the thing is, with going on a big, long bike ride, you get all of that chit-chat out the way very quickly, and before you know it, you're sort of delving into the lives of these individuals. And to be honest with you, some of the stories and what you hear is just absolutely heart-wrenching. And I think, for me, as a parent, you can't help but put yourself in their family situation and imagine what it would be like to be, living the lives that they do. And the way that Children in Need helps and everything, it is incredibly emotional. And I think as well, because it's such a tiring thing to be doing, that all the barriers and everything are stripped away very quickly, and everybody is feeling very, very vulnerable. And yeah, it is. It's one heck of a bike ride, and to be honest with you, that's why I love doing it so much. I can't believe we're in our fourth year, Terry.
No, and you've done so brilliantly for us. You're a great man. Now, who's riding at the moment?
We've just pulled in. Carolina has just ridden us to Kingsley, which is apparently, I was just talking to one of the locals there, the heart of Cheshire. So that's where we are now.
We knew that. Yes.
But I'll tell you what, goodness me, the cash that we have got this morning just from people out on the side of the road. Because the good thing is with hills, although they're bad news for the rickshaw riders, they are brilliant for the purse. And as you go up, people come out and they're giving £20 and £10. And we've just shoveled a load of notes out of our buckets and into the cars here. So we've just gone on a massive hill up to Kingsley. And then Matthew now is going to take over. Now, Matthew is an extraordinary rider. He has cerebral palsy. He really struggles with his speech, but he has this this bit of kit with him where he types in what he wants to say and he presses a button and then it speaks for him.
Yeah.
And part of this challenge this year, Terry, is to do these kind of motivational speeches or these kind of life stories to huge crowds. And yesterday, Matthew went off to the Derby County and Wolves match in front of 20,000 people, and he went out, introduced himself, and then he pressed his button on this machine and he had this extraordinary speech just all about him and how he'd ended up in the situation he was in and the help that he'd got through Children in Need. And it was played right throughout the stadium, and it's, as you can imagine, again, that not a dry eye in the house.
Oh, that's fantastic, Matt. And you're going to be finishing on the set of EastEnders, which is where an awful lot of this year's Children in Need telethon is going to be held.
We're looking forward to seeing you, Terry. To be honest with you, we can't wait to get there. It seems like a very, very long way away. And the Thursday, the day before, obviously that Friday of Children in Need, we have to start, get this right, at 2:00 in the morning.
I'm stunned.
Yeah, 2:00 in the morning to pack the miles in order to get into a position on Friday morning to cycle in. So we're doing the hours and we're covering the miles, but it's all for a brilliant cause.
Have you got the names of the children who are with you?
Yeah, I've got Caroline, I've got Jess, I've got John here, Alex is here as well, and I think Matthew's just squeezing into his Lycra before he's getting onto the bike.
Yeah, well, we wish you a safe journey, and it's a heroic journey that you take on behalf of Children in Need, Matt. Please thank all the children, and I know you've had support from Peugeot, who give us a lot of support for Children in Need as well, providing the cars.
Yeah. No, absolutely. Alfred's are here. Everybody's doing their bit as well. And have you got all the details there, Terry, of how people can show their support for donations, or do you want me to give those?
Whatever you like, Matt.
I'll tell you.
Yeah, go on.
I'll tell you. Well, we're giving people the choice of doing two different types of donations this year. So if you want to donate a fiver, all you have to do, this is on the text, by the way, you have to text the word TEAM to 70705, okay, that will be for a fiver, or 707010, that is for £10. Obviously, if you're feeling generous, that would be wonderful. So that's TEAM to 70705, or TEAM to 70710.
Matt, thank you very much, and thank you for all that you do, and please thank the children.
I will do indeed, and a big thank you to everybody that's donated so far, and if you're coming out on the route, it'd be great to see you. Thanks ever so much indeed, everyone.
Good luck to the Rickshaw Challenge for Children in Need.